me, Tom Barnes, Stories from the 78, and I love music, so I don't care where the music is, I'll go find the music, and that's where I find my friend here, Dusty Bo. How you doing, sir?
Good, brother. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you for joining me today. I appreciate it. I know you're busy. You're in your car. You're doing things because you're running around. You got a lot of stuff going on, so I appreciate it, but you're going to be here in Chicago at the Monstrose Saloon October 19th, and if people love Zeppelin, AC/DC, Jimi Hendrix, and just that type of vibe of music with a little bit, not a little bit, with modern take on it. That's you, at least from what I heard. But I want you to tell people what they should expect when they come to see one of your shows, especially the one here in Chicago.
Yeah, no, you pretty much nailed it on the head, man. Like that's kind of what I wanted to do with the album as far as like its overall sonic sound is have my influences, but with, you know, modern, you know, tweaks and hooks and stuff that made, you know, that just felt right and whatnot. But yeah, Zeppelin, Hendrix, AC/DC, Aerosmith, Standard, those are my people.
Too.
Man. Yeah, I see you got quite the collection back there. That's awesome, man. I love, that's one of, other than playing music, like, and even sometimes more than playing it, I should say, I love just sitting down in my basement and listening to my records.
Oh, me too. It's like one of my favorite, like when I first met my wife, she's a little younger than me, right? So we would, you know, like you have like a Friday night where you're bored and you got nothing going on for the first time in a while. And you're like, how about we just listen to music? And she would like, look at me like, well, what do you mean? Cause she's just from that generation where you just Spotify everything. Right. And I was like, no. You got to sit down in a room, turn the music on, turn it up loud so it sounds good, and you can dim the lights, you can do whatever, and do nothing else but just literally listen to music. And she looked at me like I was crazy. And I was like, no, I used to do that as a kid all the time, and nobody does anymore. And then we started doing it, and it's like one of our favorite, we must be, I don't know, we're weird, but I love doing that stuff.
That's not weird at all, man. Honestly, I do too, and it's something that I like. I wish that more people would really like practice it almost as like a wellness thing, like a meditation thing or whatever. It's like you put a record on, put on a vinyl, you turn, like you said, turn it up loud, sit down, and you just listen, and it just like let it take over. Don't skip nothing, even if you don't like the song, let it finish, try to, you know, I love it. That's awesome.
Yeah, did that with AC/DC's Back in Black album not too long ago, some Otis things, some Sam Cooke, you know, and you're up next, my friend.
Right on.
So for folks that want to learn about you and follow you, what's the best way for them to go about doing that as far as social medias or websites or the whole thing?
If you go to my website, dustybo.com, so it's dustybo.com. If you go there, that has all my social links, and I'm on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok, all as Dusty Vox, D-U-S-T-Y-V-O-X, and then I'm on Facebook and all that. But if you just go to dustybo.com, it has literally all my Spotify, iTunes, it has all the links there at the top, so that might be easier for people just to do that. But yeah, I'm on all of them other than Snapchat. I think I don't do Snapchat.
I don't blame you. I don't either. I can't do it.
I know there's so much, man, and it's like I tried to avoid the TikTok thing for as long as I could, but it's just like that's where everybody's at now, is unfortunately, like, it just keeps moving. And that's part of I guess doing this thing, trying to make it in music business, is like just adapting, you know, going along with the evolution.
It's a necessary
people are using. Yeah.
Well, Dusty, thank you very much for joining me. I appreciate it. And when you come to your show, how long can they expect for you to be out there playing? You know, do you, as far, run through a show real quick before we get out of here, just, you know, because people, different bands do different things during their shows. So I'm just curious.
Yeah. Well, it kind of, I've never been to the Montrose Saloon. So what we kind of do is, honestly, we have somewhat of a structured set, but we'll really play to the room and to the crowd, you know, just to kind of see what the vibe's like. Sometimes I start off doing an acoustic set and then like a solo acoustic set and then bring the band up. But then sometimes we just get right to rock. And I think just from what, because our drummer is from Chicago. So he's going to have some family in friends there, and I don't want to have them wait. You know, I want to have him on stage as much as possible. And he's an amazing drummer. Like, he's so, that's been a really fun thing having him on the road. Cause we just met in September. So like,
what's his name?
It's been really cool. His name's Nick Ling.
Well,
I believe it's Chicago. If it's not Chicago, I could be mistaken. It's close. To Chicago, but yeah. But anyways, if I had to bet, I would say that this set we'll get right to rocking with this set. So it'll be, you know, all the full band stuff, and most of the songs are fast. They're all loud, and yeah. Bring awesome. Your earplugs if you need them.
Can't wait. October 19th, Montrose Saloon, Dusty Bow. Thank you very much. We'll see you then.
Yeah, man. Thank you.
Yeah.